Hey family, it's Andrew here with a new community update, first one in quite some time. That's because, well, 2024 has just been mad. I thought it was going to be a calmer year than last year. It's just got off to a lot of unexpected things, some good, some bad, a few losses, and you probably hear from my voice, I've been a bit sick, so it's been a bit hard to put one of these together. But finally coming out of all of that and looking forward to sharing a number of really exciting things with you all in the coming weeks. For today, I just wanted to share an update about a new feature, a little small community update today, a new feature we've just released, which I know many of you have asked for some time, and it's gonna make life a little bit easier, particularly if you're living in an area where there's lots of events happening or you need to plan things in the future. It's about the ability to jump forward to a future date on the activity page. Should we take a look? All right, so if you live in an area where there's a lot of events on the activities page, you're probably familiar with how difficult it is to go ahead in time and find out if something is on a particular day at some point off in the future. Let's take a look. Here's at Sydney, just local events in Sydney, and you can see over the next few days, there's lots of events. So if I wanted to jump forward to a future month, I've got to scroll and scroll and scroll and keep scrolling and keep scrolling and keep scrolling and keep scrolling till I get to the date that I'm interested in. It's a real pain. It's a real pain. We get it, understand. And our focus has actually been on making Stitch easier for starting communities in new areas. So it took us a while to get around to this feature, but obviously now that we've got so many communities that are up and running and booming, it's really important for you to be able to say, oh yeah, what's happening in June? I'd like to schedule an event, or am I gonna be free? So it's pretty easy to find. If you just scroll up the top here and click on the filter bar, you'll now see, you know, the filter actions that we always had were there. You can change your location, choosing what you're showing, what order you're putting it in. But from, you can now have this start date. So I can choose to show me all the events from a future date. And this is our standard date picker, which you can jump forward by month. So you can actually change the year and jump ahead. But let's just take a look. If we go forward to say end of May, and see what's happening, and then search, and you'll see the date filter up the top here, just lets you know you're searching for activities from 31st of May onwards. And you see, here they all are, 31st of May. And still works as everything else works the way you'd expect, but it just means that you can then jump forward to a time to find out if things are free. If you'd like to clear it, just hit this reset button, or if you'd like to, you can always click the date filter here and just jump back to today. That's totally easy, either ones. And you know, if you need to look at a future year, you can obviously skip through month by month by month by these buttons here, May, June, July, but you can also click on the month here and then skip this way. You can even go all the way off into the future, but that's probably getting ahead of ourselves. Let's just go back to today. Set it here, and I can actually just clear my settings and I'm back to normal. So look, it's only a minor thing, but I know it'll make it a lot easier for you if you're in an area where there's lots of things up and coming, and we're working on a bunch of other things we're about to announce shortly. So hopefully you find that feature useful. Please check it out and use it, and give us feedback if you find something works differently from the way you expected or not. And as always, please give us your thoughts and ideas. This actually, we've had many suggestions for that feature over the last few months, and we just got some time to put it in. But if you've got other ideas, suggestions, and for things that you think would make the community better, please send them our way. We're always open for suggestions. All right, great to see you again. Look after yourselves, and if you can, look after someone else too. And in the meantime, happy stitching. Bye for now.